What's up, everybody? This your boy, Eric Reed's Computer Solutions. So I've been having the LG G7 for about a month now, and I want to give you my thoughts about this device, right? I think this device is being underrated in so many ways, right? Is it the perfect phone? No, it's not. But let me give you my thoughts about some of the key factors of the LG G7, some of the good and some of the bad of this device. So sit back and relax and get your popcorn ready and follow me on this journey. Let's go. What's up, guys? This is Eric again with another video. So let me give you some key thoughts about the LG G7, some good and some bad, the things that I like about the device, right? So we all know the specs already. We know that they got the A45 processor, 4 gigs of RAM. We know it got 64 gigs of internal storage. We know everything about the device. We saw many videos about that, right? So that ain't what I want to talk about today. I think the LG G7 is a little underrated. I mean, it has the same specs as the flagships, right? Of course, it doesn't have 6 gigs of RAM and 128 gigs of internal storage, right? But it does have the SD card support and all that stuff like that. So one of the key factors of owning the LG G7 is audio, right? With the quad DAC on this device, you can push high impedance headphones, which is great, right? Listen, I put high impedance headphones on the LG G7. It sounds like no other. If you like high audio, the LG devices, whether or not you're coming from the LG G6 or the LG V30, when it comes down to the quad DAC that's inside of this device, right, the LG G7, it is king supreme. I mean, if you haven't heard how the audio sound as far as with the headphones, with high impedance headphones, you would be blown away on how the LG G7 would drive high impedance headphones. That is a good quality, and that's something that I really do like about the LG G7. The next key factor that I like about the LG G7 is that the external speaker, they call it the boombox speaker, right? So when you're listening to audio on the external speakers on the LG G7, it is so loud that it does rumble because it has this resonance chamber, and it is a very good quality type audio that's coming out. Now, when you lay the device on a table, it is like no other when it comes down to audio. So I think LG focus is on good audio, right? Good headphones, quad DAC, and that is a huge key factor of the LG G7. So let me give you a little snippet of what I'm talking about when it comes down to audio on the LG G7.
All right, and so this technology kind of give you that good surround sound speaker. Now, the whole bottom of the device is actually vibrating. So the whole bottom of the device is vibrating. So when you put this on a surface like this, you get loud, very loud. Yeah, so that is very loud. Woo, man. All right.
As you can hear, I was blown away by listening to the audio on the LG G7. And again, this is one huge key factor of the LG G7, is its audio, internal and external. So thumbs up to LG for making that happen. So another key factor that I want to talk about of the LG G7 is its cameras. I record about 90% of my videos with LG devices. I'm recording this whole video with the LG G7. So you be the judge for yourself when it comes down to the quality, right? As you watch my YouTube channel, and I get a lot of compliments about how good the video and how good the audio sound on my YouTube channel. And a lot of people ask me, what DSLR that I'm using? And I always tell them I'm use LG phones to record most of my videos. And they get blown away when I tell them that. I've recorded a lot of my videos with the LG G6, but I've recently switched over to the LG G7 in manual mode and adjust some of my settings to make sure that I get very good video out of this device. So when it comes down to the cameras, I think this is a huge key factor on LG phones, right? Listen, they got a lot of phones out there that get 100% on DSLR mark, right? They got cameras out there that proclaim to be King Supreme. But when you sit back and you make your adjustments on the LG devices, you can get very good photography, very good audio, and very good videos. So another key factor of owning the LG G7 is the design, right? I like the way the phone looks. It looks very good, clean, classy. It's a device that you can pull out of your pocket and you know that it's a very premium phone. So when it comes down to the build quality, I say this with the LG G6, right? I think LG's coming out party was the LG G6 because that phone is beautiful. But when you put your hands on the LG G7, they look like they took it up a notch, which is a good thing. So when they come down to the design of the LG G7, it is King Supreme. I mean, it's a beautiful phone, but we are seeing a lot of pretty phones out there in 2018. So overall, I think when it comes down to the design of the LG G7, it's in the same realm of 2018 flagships. So good job. Good job. It's a pretty phone. So everything ain't rosy with the LG G7. Listen, I talked about some good key factors about this phone, which I really do like. But some of the things about the LG G7 that you need to know, especially for me having this phone for about a month. One of the hugest issues of having the LG G7 right now is the battery life. Listen, the battery life on this device is not that great. I'm just gonna be real with you. I'm only getting about 4 to 4.5 hours of on-screen time. Now, when I put it on power saving mode, I can get about almost close to five hours with the LG G7, and that's still not that great, but you get hit with performance. I've been topping out about 4 hours, 4.5 hours of screen on time, especially in 2018 when you have a lot of phones that can top out at about 6 hours of screen on time, 7 hours, 6.5, 7 hours of screen on time. The battery life should have been a little better on the LG G7. Maybe LG will probably send some software updates to fix the battery life on the LG G7, but I'm getting killed on battery life on the LG G7. Well, overall, it's no excuses for a device in 2018 to have 4 hours, 4.5 hours of battery life. I think that's something that could be fixed with a software update, but as of right now, third quarter of 2018, I am not seeing very good battery life on the LG G7. So another thing that I don't like about the LG G7 is the screen technology. Even though it has a notch, I'm kind of used to that, right? I think with the LCD IPS display, I'm starting to see a little light bleed coming out the corners of my device, right? Especially when you turn it on or looking at some stuff in the dark, right? I'm starting to see some edges, a little light bleeding here and there, and some of the viewing angles is not that great sometimes on this device. So I think that's some of the things that's hindering this device is the screen technology. Now, once it's on, the colors are bright and vivid. You do have 1,000 nits on this device, so outdoor visibility is very good. But I think with the light bleeding that I'm starting to see with the LG G7, it's passable, but not great. So that's something that could be improved with future devices on the LG G7. So let me give you my conclusion. I've been having the LG G7 for about a month. I like some of the unique features of this phone. The audio is King Supreme, better than any phone that I have. The cameras, as you can see, I'm using the camera to record this video. And I use LG cameras to record about 95% of all of my videos on this YouTube channel. So when it comes down to the video audio, I think it's King Supreme. When it comes down to the design, the phone is beautiful. So thumbs up for the design, right? There's no phone out there that's perfect. I think that we need to consider that when we buy these phones. We have to buy phones for what you want, right? And I think the LG G7 is a content creator's paradise, right? Is it gonna be the fastest phone on the planet? Is it gonna be a OnePlus 6? No, right? Is it gonna beat the Pixel? No. But the LG G7 has more features than the Pixel. It has more features than the OnePlus device. So when you talk about enhanced features, this device does have a lot of good things going for it. And I'm glad I have this phone in my collection, because LG phones has been very special to me, especially for content creating, right? So this is my 1 month review with the LG G7. This is Eric from Easy Computer Solutions. Leave your comments down below. Let me know what you think about the LG G7 in all its glory. See you guys on the next video. Peace.